class we will see the last chapter from the civics. So you may please take chapter 6, the subordinate chords. And here in this chapter we have to learn about the distinctions between courts of district judge and the session court and law adalats, meaning and advantages. Other things you can skip. And about the distinctions between the court of the district judge and the sessions court, it is given in your textbook page number 61 and 62. You can read that one, and I will give a note on that one because it is not that much clear in your textbook. Now I will give certain information about the differences between the court of the district judge and the court of the session court, and later I will provide the notes on that one. So the lawsuits or the complaints are broadly divided into two types, civil and criminal. A district court usually handles the cases which are civil in nature, and the jurisdiction of the district court is given in the Code of Civil Procedures 1908. And the second one, the session court, on the other hand, handles the cases which are criminal in nature. The jurisdiction of the session court is given in the Code of Criminal Procedure 1973. The first one, district court, it deals with the civil cases, and the procedure it is given in the Code of Civil Procedure. And the session court, it handles the cases of the criminal cases, and the procedure it is given in the Code of Criminal Procedure. So I hope that you understood the first difference between district judge and the session judge. And now we will see the four each differences of district court judge and the session court judge. District court judge, first one, it is the highest civil court of a district. District court judge is the, it is the highest civil court of a district. Second one, it is presided by the district court judge. Third one, these judges decide civil related cases such as divorce, will, land, property, money transactions, guardianships and arbitration. So the main cases which are dealt by the district court judge are divorce, will, land, property and etc. And finally, these judges act as deputy commissioner and district collector in their capacity, maintain law and order and supervise the collection of revenue and taxes in the district. So they have got the duty of maintaining the law and order in the society. Now we will see about the session court judge. First one, it is the highest criminal court of a district. Session court judge or the court is the highest criminal court of a district. And second one, it is presided over by the sessions court judge. Third one, these judges decide criminal related cases such as murders, theft, dacoit, pickpocketing, etc. Dacoit means a robbery, a group robbery. Fourth one, no administrative functions are performed by them. So there are a lot of differences. In earlier we have seen that district court judge, he has got administrative function, that is why he maintains the law and order. But the session court judge, he doesn't have the administrative power. I will give you the note on that one, but you can just go through the note given in your textbook first. The second topic which you have to learn from the chapter, it is the meaning of Lok Adalat and the advantages of Lok Adalat. So you may please take page number 63. Lok Adalat, it was set up by the recommendation of Justice P.N. Bhagavathy, and the main objective of Lok Adalat was to give free legal aid to the poor and the needy. So the objective of Lok Adalat is to provide free legal aid to the needy and the poor people. And it was set up on the recommendation of Justice P.N. Bhagavathy. The Lok Adalat have been set up at different states and parts of our country. Now we will see the meaning of Lok Adalat. Lok Adalat means people's court. The meaning of Lok Adalat is people courts, which encourages the settlement of disputes through compromise and settlement between the parties. So Lok Adalat, it is a court of people or people's court, which settles the disputes between two parties through compromise and settlement. And second one, a few judges of the Supreme Court, social workers, young students of law, public spirited men and women are the members of Lok Adalat. So you get an idea about the composition of Lok Adalat also. Few judges of the Supreme Court, social workers, young students of law, public spirited men and women are the members of the Lok Adalat. And these Adalat are assisted by legal aid committees and social action groups. So I hope that you know the meaning of Lok Adalat. It is people's court which settles the disputes between two parties through compromise and settlement. Now we will see the advantages of Lok Adalat. You may please take page number 64, advantages and importance of Lok Adalat. Five advantages are given there in your textbook, and you have to get all the five advantages. First one, Lok Adalat deliver speedy and inexpensive justice, not costing much. Speedy and inexpensive, that is why first we have seen it provides free legal aid to the poor and needy. Second one, they work in the spirit of compromise and understanding, hence both the parties to a dispute feel satisfied. The Lok Adalat work on compromise and understanding, so both the parties get satisfied once the dispute is settled. Third one, they reduce the workload of other courts and delay in justice. So already that we have seen, a speedy justice is given to the poor and the needy. Since Lok Adalat works other courts, it won't get much workload. Fourth one, judgment passed by the Lok Adalat is final and binding. Therefore, appeals cannot be made in any court against its award. So what are the things made in the Lok Adalat? That is final. And the last one, before taking a matter to a court of law, any party can move to Lok Adalat for the settlement of the dispute. And it doesn't mean that a person should go directly to the court. Instead of that, the person can go to the Lok Adalat for the settlement of the dispute. So that is the end of your 6th chapter, and I hope that is the end of your history syllabus also, and we will start our revision at the earliest, and I will provide some of the questions and answers. You may please go through the chapters according to your revised syllabus. Thank you. Have a nice day.